Many guitarists, maybe even yourself, play a second or third instrument. And all too often, these auxiliary instruments are treated completely separate from the guitar. Well, that changes today, because we're going to look at five different non-guitar instruments and how they can influence and elevate your guitar playing. Hey TAC family, and welcome to episode 177 of the Acoustic Tuesday Show. This show is designed to bring fun, focus, and progress to your guitar journey through my weekly Guitar Geek lists, plus success stories from your fellow guitar geeks. In fact, today, you're gonna meet TAC member AJ, who made one small, tiny change to his guitar journey, and it had an enormous impact. You're gonna learn what that change was here in just a moment, plus you're gonna get your weekly dose of acoustic guitar news, which includes a Guitar Geek watch, plenty of new music for you to check out, and quite possibly the funniest guitar cartoon I have found to date, plus a whole bunch more. But before we get into that, I want to go ahead and dig into the five non-guitar instruments that can teach you a ton about the guitar. So grab your scuba gear and let's go ahead and dive in. I am super excited for this because we're going to do this in a really fun way. Not only are you going to learn what the non-guitar instrument will teach you about guitar, you're going to get to know some other artists because I've paired each instrument with an artist that you absolutely need to know. So you're going to get some Guitar Geek information, plus you're going to find, hopefully, a bunch of new music. In fact, yeah, I'm pretty sure you're going to find at least one artist that you've never heard of before. So let's go ahead and dig in. The first instrument I want to focus on is the banjo. What can the banjo teach you about guitar? It seems like a completely separate instrument. Actually, it can teach you a ton about the guitar. Number one, navigating open tunings. Banjo is tuned to, commonly, open G. And if you learn how to navigate open G, that tuning is actually not that different than the open G on guitar. So anything you learn on the banjo, you can actually translate to a guitar that's tuned to open G. That's just one thing though. There's some technique elements that you can bring to the guitar from the banjo as well. Number one is basic finger picking rolls and patterns. They're not that much different between the banjo and the guitar. So if you learn them on the banjo, you can bring them right over to the guitar, whether you play an open G tuning or simply standard tuning. Not to mention, on the banjo, you can play it with finger picks if you play bluegrass style, and that translates to guitar as well. But check this out. There's also old-time banjo, or clawhammer style banjo, and for those of you who know Molly Tuttle, you're pretty familiar with clawhammer. And you can take that clawhammer style from the banjo and actually apply it to the guitar as well. And I've got two artists that exemplify both aspects of banjo playing, and it just so happens that they're playing together. Yes, indeed, Bella Fleck on the bluegrass style banjo, or the three-finger style banjo, and Abigail Washburn on the old-time style banjo. And while you watch this next clip, I want you to look at the techniques that they're both using and imagine those techniques applied to the guitar. Let's check it out. The next instrument on my list is the mandolin. And you might be thinking to yourself, okay, the mandolin's tiny, but it has strings and it has frets, so I'm sure that there's something you can carry from the mandolin to the guitar. Yes, indeed, there are two things that I want to highlight here, and the first is a technique. Number one is tremolo. Yes, tremolo is that kind of steady back and forth movement of the pick on one single note that ekes out or pulls out the emotion of that note. You can take that technique from the mandolin and apply it directly to the guitar, and it translates beautifully. So that's one thing. The second thing is more of a navigation thing. The mandolin is tuned symmetrically. It's tuned in fifths, G, D, A, E. Since it's tuned in fifths, there are a lot of symmetrical patterns that lay out across the strings. And since the mandolin, again, I'll name that tuning from low to high, G, D, A, E, is simply the opposite of the guitar, which is tuned low to high, E, A, D, G, if you look at those low four strings, a lot of the patterns that you can learn on the mandolin can carry over directly to the guitar. They're just upside down. So it's really nice to be able to play the mandolin, visualize these patterns, and then take those patterns and apply them to the guitar because it opens up a whole world of navigation. Now you might be thinking, that sounds cool. I think I could get into that, but I need a little bit more motivation. I need some inspiration. Well, John Reichman is here to give you some inspiration. John Reichman is a mandolin player you absolutely need to know about because he's one of the best melodic players I have personally ever heard. So let's go ahead and check out John right now. Next is an instrument with four strings, and yes, it is the almighty bass. Whether you play upright bass or electric fretted bass, it doesn't matter, you can still pull lessons from the bass and apply them to the guitar. Number one, because it's tuned the exact same. The four strings of the bass, E, A, D, G, are the exact same low four strings of the guitar, E, A, D, G. So anything you do on the bass, you can directly translate to the guitar. That's pretty cool. But the bass can also teach you the power of single note riffs, or, well, bass lines on the bass. Oftentimes, when you hear a bass line in a song, you can mimic that on the guitar, and it can have a huge impact on what you're able to offer rhythmically. Because, yeah, while it may not be a chord, and you might be simply outlining the chord, you can still do that on the acoustic guitar, and it can still create this wonderful rhythmic texture. Now, two of my favorite bass players, one in the upright category, one in the electric bass category, I found a clip of them playing together, so you need to know about both of them. Number one is Edgar Meyer, a fantastic upright bass player and somebody, a musician I've looked up to for quite some time when I first heard him play with Jerry Douglas. And the second is none other than Victor Wooten, an all-around bass maestro that you need to know about in the electric bass category. So let's go ahead and watch them play together. I've combined two instruments for this next slot on the list, and they are the violin and the dobro. Now you might be thinking to yourself, Tone, you can't do that. You can't combine instruments. The violin and the dobro, they don't seem related at all. Well, first, I'm making the rules and I can do whatever I want. But second, the violin and the dobro are actually much more closely related than you may realize. And the reason I lump them together is because they are essentially fretless instruments. So what can a fretless instrument teach you about the guitar, which has frets? Here's a couple of things, actually. Number one, the dobro, for example, can teach you slide technique, which you can apply to the guitar. Yeah, it's a little bit different because lap slide, you're looking down at the strings and using a different type of slide, whereas with guitar, you're using a bottleneck slide and looking at the guitar vertically, but that's okay. The same techniques can apply from the dobro to the guitar in terms of slide approach and general slide technique. So that's just one thing. But the second thing that both the violin and the dobro embody that you can bring to the guitar is the vocal quality that a stringed instrument can have. The violin and the dobro don't have frets. So you can get these wonderful vocal qualities, or the quote-unquote notes between notes. You can pull those notes out of the violin or the dobro. But you might be thinking, okay, wait a minute, whoa, stop the train here, Tone, because the guitar has frets. There are no notes between the notes. But there actually are, because we can do bends on the guitar that mimic those notes between notes. So things you hear on the violin, things you hear on the dobro, things you play on the violin or the dobro actually can be mimicked on the guitar. You just have to tune your ear to listen to what you're looking for, or something like that. But two of my favorite players actually found them together. One is a violin player, fiddle player, the other is a dobro player. Casey Dreesen on the fiddle, Rob Ikes on the guitar. And I want you to check these two folks out because, wow, they're mind-blowing musicians, but they also share some of these techniques that, well, I was just talking about. Let's have a look.
I'm
Thus far, all of the instruments that I've mentioned, the banjo, the mandolin, the bass, the violin, and dobro, all have strings. This final instrument I'm going to share with you doesn't have any strings at all. It's the harmonica. What on earth can the harmonica teach you about the guitar? Actually, quite a bit, and there are three big ones that I want to point out. The first one is scales. Because the harmonica is essentially a diatonic scale, you can take your knowledge and playing of the harmonica and apply it to the guitar. Which actually brings me to the next big thing the harmonica can teach you about the guitar, and that is ear training. The harmonica is so wonderful for ear training because it is a diatonic scale. You start to listen to those notes and their relationships differently. But you can take that same ear training, that same knowledge you gather from the harmonica, and use that ear training on the guitar. Once you train your ear, you can actually apply it to any musical instrument. But the last thing, and probably the most important thing, that I want you to take from the harmonica and apply it to the guitar is breath. And you might be thinking, Tone, we're not talking about running here. What do you mean breath? I'm talking about breath in terms of space. When you play the harmonica, you quite simply have to breathe, otherwise you will pass out. It's impossible to infinitely breathe out or breathe in. We're just not built that way as humans. So you have to take a breath when you play the harmonica. And the breath provides space. And the beautiful thing about that is we can take that notion of space and apply it to the guitar. It's one of the most important things you can bring to your guitar playing is space. And I found a wonderful example from a wonderful harmonica player, somebody that you need to know about from the blues realm, and that is Junior Wells. We're gonna listen to him play here for a little bit, and I want you to take note of the space that he imparts on the song and during his solo. It's incredible, it's inspirational, but just think of how that space would translate to the guitar. It's pretty mind-blowing, in my opinion. Now I've got two questions for you. Number one, if you play an instrument besides the guitar, let me know in the comments below. Make sure to tell me what it is. And the second question I have for you is, I only named five instruments and what they would teach you about the guitar. I'm sure I missed something, so in the comments below, let me know what I missed and also what that instrument would teach you about the guitar or how the lessons learned on that instrument would translate to the guitar. I can't wait to hear what you come up with. Let's now shift our focus to guitar geek and TAC family member AJ. AJ made one small tweak in his guitar journey and it had an enormous impact. It was his inclusion of the 10-minute rule into his playing. Here's what he has to say. The best part about Tony's acoustic challenge so far for me is I play a lot. It was the worst feeling after sitting down for an hour and feeling like I didn't accomplish anything. I played, but nothing to help me. I figured the longer I played, the better I would just become. Now, if I just pick it up for 10 minutes and know what it is I'm working on, I can see improvement. Yes, just after 10 minutes. It's crazy. I learn more in these 10-minute sessions than I do in the old hour. I don't have four different things going on at the same time. I just choose two lessons and stick with that. I'm having a blast, and today I actually smiled when I wiped my guitar off after playing. First and foremost, huge thanks to AJ for sharing this, and I want to highlight a few things. The first is the 10-minute rule. Playing for 10 minutes a day is hugely impactful. The common myth, and AJ even referred to it in his story, is that the more hours you put into playing the guitar, the better you will be. That's not true. Yes, of course, I want everybody to practice. However, it's what you do in those practice sessions that defines and charts your progress going forward. If you play the same thing every day for hours and hours a day, you simply won't get past playing the same thing. You won't get any better. And as AJ put so eloquently in his story, if he plays for 10 minutes, he knows what he's going to work on, then he can focus for those 10 minutes and he does feel progress. That's how powerful that 10-minute rule is, combined with setting your intention, knowing what you're going to work on for the day. So I guess what I'm saying here is don't always think that time in equals skills out. Yes, it's time in, but it's what you do in that time that helps, again, chart your progress forward. And I'd much rather you get a consistent playing routine where you play 10 minutes a day than you have these dabbles and fits and starts where you play for an hour a day here and then it's 2 weeks go by and then again you play for another hour. Try and play 10 minutes a day because it truly does have an enormous impact on your guitar journey, just as AJ said in his story. Now let's go ahead and move on to a guitar arsenal. We're gonna head down to Mineral Bluff, Georgia, which sounds like just a darn cool place. I think of cliffs and maybe a river, but I've never been there. I don't know, but we're gonna go visit Jim in Mineral Bluff, Georgia. Here's Jim and here's what he has in his guitar arsenal. From left to right, a Taylor 114 CE, a 2011 Gibson Les Paul Jr., a 1996 Fender Lone Star Strat, a fine example of a guitar geek, a Blue Ridge BR-160A, a Macaulay Uke, a Takamine EG-523 SC 12 string, a 1993 Takamine EG-334 RC, and on the wall, a Republic Dobro. Each guitar has a story that goes along with them. My ever-supportive wife bought three of them for me, the Taylor, the Takamine 6 string in 1993, and the Dobro. The Les Paul was a retirement present from my team, and I bought the 12 string, the Strat, and the Blue Ridge. The amp in the back is a Carvin all-tube 50-watt head with a 4x10 cabinet. I also have an old Crate 60-watt acoustic amp, and I finally have been able to get my tone the way I want it after watching your video on the amp settings. Well, thank you so much, Jim, for sharing your guitar arsenal with us. And if you're sitting there thinking, I want to be like Jim, I want to share my guitar arsenal on the Acoustic Tuesday show, I'm saying please do so. Just follow these three simple steps. Step number one, go to acoustictuesday.store and pick out your favorite guitar arsenal shirt. Step number two, once that shirt arrives, take a picture amongst all of your guitars. And step number three, upload that picture at acousticlife.tv. Once you're there, click on the submit link in the top menu and you can go ahead and upload your picture and tell your story just like Jim did. Now let's go ahead and turn back the clock, the sands of time, if you will, and visit episode 175 of the show, where we talked about Jerry Garcia and really what made him a guitar guru. In fact, I've got some interesting comments from that show. One of them I got a little bit of flack about, and we'll get to that comment here in a moment, but let me go ahead and pull up a few of these comments. Our first one comes from a Japanese viewer, and this is from Sato. Hopefully I said that correctly. Hi, Tony. I'm a Japanese watcher of your YouTube program. I manage to understand the contents every time. I really love listening to others' music, playing my guitars, and preparing and building guitars by myself. Your content satisfies my interest in many aspects. I will continue listening to you. Thank you again. Well, thank you for watching. It's so cool to know that guitar geeks from around the world are watching the Acoustic Tuesday show. So cheers to you, Sato. And again, thanks so much for watching. Our next comment comes from Fred Lazarus. And he says this, it's more of a question really. Where is that shirt from? Not on your website. So you have a mystery shirt and hat on the desk. Let me go ahead and put some rumors to rest. The shirt, it was an unplugged shirt, one of my favorite shirts actually, both because it looks cool in my opinion and it feels really nice, was a gift from Whitney's parents to me. I think it was for either my birthday or Christmas, but I wanna say the brand of that shirt is Wanderlust. I'm pretty sure. I'll actually throw a link down below when I do a little bit more research and find out where that shirt came from, but I'm pretty sure it's Wanderlust. As for this wonderful hat here, a little birdie told me that you might be able to pick those up sometime in the very near future, and I'll certainly let you know when that time is. You might be able to pick up that hat and some other different kind of hats and a couple different shirts and maybe even some stickers. I don't know, but I'll certainly tell you when that time comes up. Our next comment comes from Bill Chapura, and this was in response to a question I asked where I was like, hey, what's your favorite Grateful Dead song? Give me the date, give me the show, give me the title of the song. And he brought in the acoustic realm here, and this is so cool, and it actually leads to the next comment. We'll get there in a second. Bill says, Guitar, Space, and Summertime. Jerry Garcia, David Grisman, and Tony Rice from the Pizza Tapes. An excellent album, by the way. It's one of the best pieces I've ever heard on acoustic guitar, especially since they didn't know where that was going to go. Even they were impressed by what they had done. Quote, we did some serious delving on that, and we really should go listen to it. To which Jake Fruman replied, "Oh yeah, that's a good one. It reminds me of an acoustic Dark Star almost." What an awesome deep dive there, Bill, and a great album. Again, I mentioned that during your comment, but the Pizza Tapes is, to me, one of the coolest convergences of three incredible musicians: David Grisman, Jerry Garcia, and Tony Rice. For those of you who haven't heard the Pizza Tapes, please check them out. Maybe from your local library. There was a lot of chatter on that show about my comment about renting CDs and records from the library. I'm glad to know that that's still a thing that can be done. The next comment, which is actually related to the last, is from Lowell Calavera, and he says this: "What happened to acoustic life? Why not discuss Jerry Garcia's acoustic band? Jerry actually saw himself as a roots musician first. Almost Acoustic is a record that shows this very well, as did several excellent recordings with Tony Rice, John Kahn, David Grisman, and others. He played the lap steel on Teach Your Children by Crosby, Stills, and Nash, and he was a good banjo player as well." Absolutely, Lowell, I couldn't agree with you more, and that's the whole point of featuring Jerry Garcia in the first place. It was maybe less of a focus on what he's done musically, because I think his reputation is pretty amazing in that regard, and more about what he said and his approach to music, whether that was with the Dead, with his acoustic band, or with, you know, playing with David Grisman. No doubt Jerry Garcia was an amazing acoustic musician, which I think is pretty easy to tell with the company he kept and who he was able to play with. So, I mean, great call out there, Lowell. Definitely, again, that's why Jerry was included on the show, because he really is an iconic musician as a whole. And I think his approach and philosophy is something that we all need to dive into and be reminded of every now and again. And then lastly, Ben Lawless put in a great quote from Jerry, and he says this, quote, "Truth is something you stumble into when you think you're going someplace else." Of course, attributed to Jerry Garcia. I want to thank everybody for their comments on that show. It really led to some awesome discussion. Some great songs were posted and dates of various Dead shows. And just, again, I just want to take a moment and thank you for being a part of this wonderful Guitar Geek community. The amazing and insightful discussion that happens is so cool. And it's, again, I'm always humbled by the fact that people from around the world gather every Tuesday to watch the show. So I guess what I'm saying is thank you. Now it's time for one of my favorite parts of the show, and that is acoustic guitar news you can use. Yes, indeed, it is my responsibility to help you stay on the front lines of what's happening in the acoustic guitar world, whether that be new albums, new instruments, or just quite simply things you need to know about. So let's dig in. The first thing I discovered here was a new song released by Sierra Hall. I don't think this is on an album yet, but I have to say, it's been so cool to see Sierra really upping her content, her YouTube content. She's put out some amazing guitar demos, some great footage of just her playing, and then I find this song on a Monday morning, and I'm digging the song. The song's called Redbird. We're going to hear it in just a moment. But when I'm looking at the credits, one of the writers, Andrew Petroff, is an acquaintance of mine, and he actually helped produce my second album, my EP, Driftwood. So it was really a full circle moment. I'm listening to this awesome song. I see the credits. Andrew Petroff's name is in there. And then I'm like, holy smokes, he produced my album. And here he is writing this amazing song. I keep talking about this song. Let's go ahead and listen to it. This is Redbird by Sierra Hall. Next up is some more new music. This is an album coming out April 23rd, 2021. It's entitled Tapered Point of Stone, and it's coming to us from Eli West. Eli is a great musical friend of mine. I've had the chance to play with him a couple of times, and he always blows my mind. Just an incredible musician. You can hand him anything with strings, and he'll play it amazingly well. Now, if you have not heard Eli before, let's go ahead and do so right now. Thank you. Some great stuff from Eli. Now, I should mention that wasn't a song off of his new album. I just wanted to give you a taste of his playing. Again, his new album comes out April 23rd, 2021. You can pre-order it right this very second from his Bandcamp page. In fact, that's something that I still need to do. So I'm going to get on that as soon as I finish recording the show because, holy smokes, I'm sure it's going to be a dandy. I've listened to one track from it and yeah, you're in for a treat with that one. The next piece of news I have for you comes from my home. I was sitting at home last week and the UPS man knocked on my door, to which he dropped off a guitar-shaped box. I then opened that box and what appeared, this sounds like the night before Christmas, but what appeared when I opened that guitar box? Well, it was a wonderful guitar from the folks at Mule Resonator Guitars. It's the Mavis. Yes, the Mavis. And just to show you how incredible this instrument is, check out these pictures. This is a jaw dropper. Mavis is, I'm gonna call it a hybrid of sorts between a resonator guitar and an electric guitar. It does things no other instrument can do. And if you wanna hear it played, this is my little ploy to get you to come over to Instagram. Make sure to follow tac.guitar on Instagram, tac.guitar. You'll see some footage of me while having just a fine time with that Mavis. In fact, I've posted quite a few videos so far and wow, just wow. It's something you have to hear. It's something you have to hear, but you have to go to Instagram to hear it. For those of you who don't do Instagram, don't worry. I'll bring some footage over here one of these days, but not today. I gotta get you over to Instagram. Next up on my list is another musician you need to know about. A fantastic fiddle player, but he does not only play the fiddle. He plays the mandolin and he plays the guitar, which makes me wonder how many lessons he's pulled from the fiddle and the mandolin and applied to guitar. Kind of what we talked about today. Pretty cool connection, right? Well, I want to introduce you to Jeremy Garrett. Jeremy Garrett is best known as the fiddle player for the infamous String Dusters, but he is a hell of a songwriter, and as I mentioned, fiddle, mandolin, and guitar player as well. He released a new album. I guess it's not new anymore, but it's an album you need to be aware of. It's called Circles, released last year, January 2020, and, well, you got to check it out. Let's go ahead and dig in and listen to a sample right now.
But I have sown. I'm finally facing all my demons. Yeah, I'm trying to get right with my soul. But I can't lay your loving down. I can't lay your loving down.
Now a piece of news from Waverly Tuners. They're getting ready to release a set of high gear ratio tuners. I believe the gear ratio on these tuners is 21 to 1. Now I've already loved Waverly Tuners. I've already thought that they operate so smoothly and look incredible. But they're gonna take smoothness of operation to a whole nother level. Yes, 21 to 1 gear ratio on these tuners. I don't believe they are out yet, but keep your eyes peeled because these are sure to be darn amazing. Now, speaking of looking good, this next piece of news is, well, it's a watch. It's a Guitar Geek watch from the folks at Original Grain. Yes, indeed, Original Grain and Taylor Guitars combined to make a Guitar Geek infused watch that actually benefits guitars for vets. Check this out.
Authenticity starts with tradition, and nothing says tradition like the trusted tone of Taylor Guitars. Born in San Diego with an instinct for innovation and a passionate attention for handcrafted excellence. That's why Original Grain and Taylor Guitars are coming together to bring you San Diego craftsmanship at its finest for a timepiece that resonates. With signature urban ash, ebony wood from Cameroon, and abalone inlays, this limited edition collection features a Taylor Hardshell inspired case, and 10% of proceeds will benefit local Guitars for Vets and Tree San Diego. We designed this watch with intention and paid attention to every detail.
There are three options of that watch available, one of which I believe is sold out, so there are only two options left, and these are available in limited quantities. So if you dig them, make sure to act fast. Now, I want to go ahead and leave you with one more piece of news, and it's really more of a cartoon. Think of this as the Guitar Funnies section of your acoustic news you can use. Yes, it is a spouse saying to their significant other, if you go out that door to buy one more guitar, we're done. To which the guitar geek responds by going out the window to find the loophole in that statement. Pretty amazing stuff. And if any of you try that at home, just be safe. Don't fall from the window. On that note, I think it's a great time to conclude the Acoustic Tuesday show, but let's take a sneak peek into next week. Next week, since it's St. Patrick's Day, we'll be talking about Irish and Celtic guitarists. Yes, I'm going to share some artists with you that you simply need to know about. That's all happening next week on the Acoustic Tuesday show, and remember, you can catch the show every single Tuesday at 10 a.m. here on YouTube. I want to thank you for joining me today. I want to thank you for being a guitar geek, and I want to remind you that your guitar success, your guitar progress, however you define it, is directly related to your guitar routine. So invest the time in your guitar routine and make sure to have fun every single day that you play. Thanks again for joining me today. Guitar Geeks Unite, and I'll see you next Tuesday on the Acoustic Tuesday Show. Cheers.